Hey there, seventh graders. So before you left, I gave you a bag that had these two items in it. You've got a handout that looks like this, and let's read through this. Mrs. Tobin's art students are teaming up with Mrs. Meadows. You will be working in art to create your own unique fabric design. When you move on to life skills next quarter, you will use the fabric you've created to make a face mask. Here are the materials you will be using in class. So, obviously you got your 8 1/4 by 6 1/4 piece of white fabric. You are also going to be using a regular pencil. And then eventually you'll be using some fabric markers. Those are obviously not materials I would expect for you to have at your house. In preparation for our in-class work, please think about what kind of design you would like to create. Create a practice sketch in the box below. So that's this box right here. Sketch first in pencil, and then if you'd like to, you can fill in colors with markers or colored pencil just to practice where you think you'd like those colors to go. You can create any design you think you'd love. Think carefully about what would look good on a mask. And here are some suggestions. You could do a favorite pattern or design, a favorite book, movie, TV, or game design, a favorite band or musician, or a favorite quote, saying, meme, etc. And again, those are just suggestions. You do not have to stick to those. If you have something else in mind, that's fine too. So the first step to coming up with your design, obviously, is to think about what you'd like to make. Now you're welcome to come up with any design you'd like to out of your imagination. You do not have to use an image that you've seen someplace. But if you'd like a little bit of help, you might want to think about something that you could find by doing a simple search on the internet. You might remember earlier on in the school year, I told you that I am a huge fan of the Gilmore Girls. So I went into Google and I did a search for Gilmore Girls clip art. Clip art is something that I really like to use when I'm creating something and I need a reference because it gives you a more simplified version of whatever it is you're looking for. Now, of course, you don't have to use the clip art version of something. That is totally up to you. So I came up with all kinds of cool stuff here. And I think I'm gonna go with this Luke's coffee cup that is a very, very popular image from the Gilmore Girls series, and I think it would look fantastic on a mask. So I'm gonna save that to my photos. All right, let's move on to the next step and see how we're gonna use this image. All right, so we're moving on to the next step. I've got my Luke's coffee cup image sitting off to the side here. And I'm gonna be doing a pre-sketch of it in this space right here. You can see that the fabric that I gave you is pretty much exactly about the same size as that space. So that's why we're gonna be working to do a practice sketch right here. Now to do this, I normally start with simplified shapes and kind of get more specific from there. So I'm gonna show you how I'll get it started and then we'll speed things up a little bit. So to make the coffee cup, I'm just gonna come in and really lightly sketch with a pencil. You may not even be able to see my pencil lines that well. And I'm just gonna kind of get a basic shape here. And I'm thinking very carefully about how it fits into the space because I would wanna make it fit into that same space when I move it over to the fabric. All right, so we're gonna start to write Luke in here. Okay. So here is my preliminary sketch. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna make this look a little bit more detailed before we go ahead and transfer it onto the fabric. So So let's speed this process up. Alright, so here you see, I've got my completed design here in my practice area. All I used was a pencil, and then I did take an ultra fine tip Sharpie and I went over all of my pencil lines with that, and then I erased any pencil lines that I didn't need with my eraser. If you don't have a Sharpie at home to use, that's totally fine. You could use another type of marker, of course, or you could just skip that step altogether and move on to the next step, which is transferring it to the fabric. So let's take a look at that. So as you can see, my fabric does fit into that space really nicely. And the reason that I outlined my drawing with that marker was so that I could place my fabric down, and now I can really easily see that image through the white fabric. Now I'm gonna tape this in place so it doesn't scoot around on me, and we're gonna speed things up again. So here we go. So you just watched me transfer this onto my fabric. Now, like I said, I did use some tape to hold it in place so that the fabric and the paper didn't shift around on me. If you don't have masking tape at home, that's okay. You could just hold the fabric in place. You could maybe also even use paper clips if you have those at home, or even just scotch tape, which is like the kind of tape you would use to wrap a present. That could hold it down too as well. So let's take it off and see how we did. All right, well, I do have a very nice light sketch of my loops design on my fabric, and you can see I very easily was able to transfer it from the paper, which is why I outlined it with that very dark Sharpie. Now, again, if you don't have a marker at home, I think even just using a nice dark pencil line would enable you to see it pretty easily once you lay that fabric on top. Now, if you need to erase on the fabric, you might have seen me in that video erasing a few times. You can kind of erase pencil off of this fabric, but it can't be pencil that is extremely dark. It has to be a really, really light pencil line. And then it will come up off the fabric pretty well. But don't count on erasing on the fabric too much. You need to pretty much make all your mistakes here on this paper, which is why I'm having you pre-plan what you want your design to look like. All right, well, those are the only two steps that you have to do while you are at home. Again, we're gonna be using color and adding color with fabric markers once you're back in the classroom. Thanks, everybody.